Being asked who has the most total development. Good question.
Do we happen to have a handy ledger page?
If only we did. So yeah. Development. Persia amongst the players has the most development, swiftly followed by Inca. And the Ottomans still trounce out Persia by a fair bit, though.
Well, request to see the religious map mode. Are you feeling generous?
Wow, when it comes to sheer ducatry, Inca have over 10 grand.
Well, Inca basically love their gold.
Don't they just? All right, religion. Quite the mishmash here. We had a fairly successful Protestant movement, and as was historical, Protestantism took great roots in Italy.
And it happens all the time. More often than you think.
Oh wow, even over to Bosnia and very nice. Okay, but otherwise, like the only reformed we have is around the Swiss. That might be why the French were picking on them. Inti making its way into Iberia, Sunni Great Britain. That's what I remember.
Yeah, I mean that's.
And then we have just the mess over here. Shia and Hindu working side by side, and Coptic being wiped out by Hindu here.
Yeah, well,
it'd be a sad tale for
clearly,
Ethiopia.
You know, it was the way it was meant to be.
And the Mahayana faith doing very well over in China as well. In fact, Confucianism really only being held up by Korea themselves.
Yeah, I think it's part of their welfare policy.
Yes, indeed. And of course, New World, we got Inti to the south, Sunni to the north. With some other minorities around there.
But some minority religion I've not quite heard about. I'm sure it'll never catch on. No.
It'll never stick. So I hope that helps you out there. Are the Shinto mechanics in this build? I'm led to believe so. I guess we never jumped in to check. Okay, no, the incidents didn't go in because we put this in after we started. But they still have their own isolationism level, which is stuck at adaptive. I guess without the incidents,
They will remain adaptive.
They will remain adaptive. Well, they certainly adapted to the situation here. No Yamana means, well, no Yamana.
Yes. And he's now marching off inland, obviously, to get that war score.
Aye. Would have thought he'd had everything he needs here. Oh, no, 66%, not quite enough. The thing is, it's about those battles. He lost so many that he didn't get the war score from it. Yeah. In fact, he's actually at negative war score from the battles. Korea had to pitch in for that one.
Oh, here comes a very fair central peace offer, I'm sure.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4 provinces. I'm sure that's all he's looking for.
And a province to Kanemburno, though. Don't forget about that one.
Wow. Okay. Mali now own the manga.
No. Okay,
it's been the province. It's completely autonomous, and it's burning down from devastation here. But the manga's manga.
Dude's bad, man.
I think the stream went down, though, since everybody is yelling RIP. So, Blondie is on the case.
Yeah, we'll find out if it's true or not.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'd love to go, oh man, now we can say and do whatever we want, but then there are those pesky YouTube viewers who get all the deleted scenes.
Alright, yeah, we're still recording.
Yeah, so if you're watching this in the future.
Yes.
Then
and now if you're watching it in the past, well done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you could be killing Hitler, but you decided to watch this stream instead.
Well, that's what I would do.
Get your priorities straight.
Yeah, well, Hearts of Iron's great for business. Yeah. So.
That would be lasting damage.
Yes.
Okay, so apparently Yamana died and so did the stream. So connection going on here.
Yes, let's see. Can Blondie get her stream up? Oh!
Okay, apparently we're live again.
We're live. We're doing well.
Yeah. Yamana's death kills the stream as well, but no, yes. Welcome back. Okay, and the letter Z not keen to tell us what happened with
we did ask him nicely what was going on.
The D-Notion Alliance. Well,
oh, Tom. Yes.
Well, he hasn't got it back, although he did allow this military access, so what could it all mean? I guess Korea can just sit back and smoke the points, though, so do they even have to worry about Uesugi anymore?
I don't know, you know, it's, as you say, you're just like a geographical construct now.
Nah, I mean, these islands, what are they ever doing for you?
Nothing good will happen.
I think Korea took Ryukyu or Okinawa, and that's all they were after. I wonder if that's what it looks like over there. I
mean, I'm pretty sure it does.
No. You know, this is the one that I take issue with. It's,
yeah, you know,
it's not the Western Isles I know.
No. People, and unlike most of the provinces, I've actually been to the Western Isles.
Yeah. Yeah, me too. Had some great fish there.
I have to say, though, the ferry wasn't... It went from Skye, not from wherever the hell that is.
Where would this be?
I have no idea. Ullapool? Looks like Ullapool. Got the ferry from Uig, though.
It's not from Dornoch.
Dornoch's next to Inverness. I mean,
that'd be a long way around.
Yeah. And it's also inland, isn't it? It's some ferry.
The land ferry.
Yes, the land ferry. Ethiopian war, they're calling out. No, I think Ethiopia is still at war with...
It's just Yamana.
Oh, it's...
I think everybody's pouncing on poor Yamana.
Yeah, I think Gnevron will be next.
Well, he's ready for the comeback here.
Yeah, comeback kid is coming back.
Persia's still involved in that Ottoman war, and have they got any war score or war participation of their own? Oh, of course not.
No, that's Persia, best ally.
Yeah. I wonder if the Ottomans will be rethinking this relationship.
Why Brunei, not Brunei in Britain? Has Daniel moved his capital?
Looks like he has. He's got London.
London is now the capital of Brunei.
Okay, he's celebrating by building an enormous fortress there, recruiting some new royal mortars.
Because everyone needs a royal mortar.
And, of course now he's done a big transformation on how the cities look over in London.
Yes.
Looking decidedly Japanese now.
Bit remodeling there. Mm-hmm. The Tower of London's still standing, good to see.
This would never catch on.
What, British Ireland?
Well, there's still an Irish core there over in Thomond.
Yeah, well.
They could yet rise again. Not for much longer, I think, though. No, they'll be gone off the map soon, but Irish still exist. Hey, might be very fitting if he manages to get Ireland.
Interesting observation is, has Daniel culture switching?
We could have a quick peek here. He hasn't told us not to.
No, he didn't mention anything like that because, obviously... Oh, he now accepts English as a culture.
And
now,
it's...
if he destroyed Great Britain, could he become Great Britain?
He could.
And then he would get the British ideas instead of his high-quality Brunei ideas.
The thing is, he's done his colonizing, really, so he doesn't really need this colonist anymore. And there's nothing really military in this set, and I think he'd want some more military might. Especially when he has Dai Viet breathing down his neck. Korea, also an enemy of his. I don't think that was the case earlier.
He's added Korea's list of enemies. He's also got the Ottomans not liking him.
But is he doing any cultural conversion? I'm not seeing it. So he might do it. We could actually look at the decisions here.
Embrace Icelandic
identity. That'll be what he's going for.
That would just be so awesome.
He's 3 out of 4 on it. All he has to do is reduce himself to 3 or fewer cities.
He can do this.
Yeah.
I believe in you, Daniel.
Change country to Iceland, gain tax and production over in Reykjavik.
That's a lot of tax, so I mean, I could see why I'd be tempted. I'd be thinking about it.
Becoming Iceland as well. Tempting. Mm. Running some policies too. Mining Act. Hired adventurers and the Stamp Act. So he's looking to really capitalize on that dosh.
It's definitely not.
He's looking pretty flush. Yeah. I mean, I've seen flush in my time.
Yes, I've seen poorer countries.
I wonder what the Inca's even going for here, because they're just...
Inca Minor.
Inca Minor. What in the world is this? A client state has been set up under Inca, so essentially...
Wasn't that Pasai's?
Yeah, it was.
Oh, dear.
Once upon a time, Pasai owned this.
Oh.
And now it's Inca Minor. Does that mean they're going down the mines there?
Possibly.
Must be stuff down here.
Well, it's got Paraguay looking very shapely.
Paraguay have no friends. And only one enemy. I don't think Portuguese Brazil can really register on anybody's radar as a real enemy.
It's not the biggest enemy, oh.
So we got sadness. Not even salt, just sadness coming in from Daniel.
Yes, because he's running out of friends.
Aww.
But however, I think
he's got Naples.
Yeah.
He's got Kiowa. I mean, look, Kiowa's half a continent here.
And it's
not the best half.
Nah, but you can't have it all, though, can you? No.
More golden half.
Yes.
In Naples, I mean, Johan has shown that he's very good at jumping in wars.
Yes.
And bending the knee to Dai Viet, who is his enemy. Yeah, so well,
clearly someone is hedging his bets. Mm. But I think once Brunei becomes Iceland...
Yeah, then no one is going to be going for his land if he just becomes Iceland.
Yes, I mean, we can see the exit here.
Mm. This is the exit strategy. I mean, it already says Brunei and Iceland. Just go for it.
Yeah. Just, you know, go the final fool hog.
Yeah, I like the fact he's put conscription centres up in Iceland as well, though. I mean, I don't think the Icelandic would take too well to being conscripted by Malayan people coming on over.
Yeah, but it's either that or becoming whale hunters, so, yeah. I mean, it's... Oh, now D-Note has his... Oh, yeah, Meng Yang's turn to take
it. Yeah, Meng Yang's taking it over in Yamana.
Yeah,
so Uesugi's taking their victory card there and there.
Just be pouring them up.
And then, okay, Velfair has managed to secure their victory card, and the points are going up, which means they're cored. So what's Meng Yang doing? Do Meng Yang have victory
card? Meng Yang just taking some... Oh!
Oh, I didn't notice that before. Meng Yang have a victory card over on Shanxi. And that's not the only victory card they've got. They never managed to finish off Sondaway for their southern victory card. Got East Bengal, but that's about it. But I think Meng Yang's really... climbing up the board for score here. In fact, well, if we just check it for players and actually go to score comparison, yeah, Meng Yang's really far down and unlikely
table
to...
there, but you know, 5,000 extra score would definitely get into respectable ranks.
Persia's really pushing forward though, just through gain of score. They might end up in top three alone.
Quite a lot of that from military, I wonder how.
But here's the thing, when 1750 rolls around, Persia's going to get another victory card. It would be on quite likely Dai Viet, very likely Vijayanagar.
Possibly Meng Yang?
Possibly Meng Yang.
Not the Ottomans. Don't think it'll be the Ottomans.
It could be, but I can't remember the exact weighting on it, but I think it's more weighted towards player on player.
Player on player action.
Trying to think how this would go down. If it was Vijayanagar, do you think the Star Nine could resist 7,000 points of victory card on his ally?
Oh.
Now, you said before there's a difference between being tempted
and tempted.
Giving in to temptation.
He will be tempted.
Will he do the latter?
I'm not sure if he could, if he would. Star Nine has proved himself very, very loyal. I mean, he lost out in the last stream on the final round. All because he wouldn't betray his allies. Yeah, so I would say that Star Nan has proven that he can resist temptation.
Sure, but that would be resisting getting a placement trophy as well.
Yeah, well...
I don't think it would be on Meng Yang, but I don't think he would really stop mowing down Meng Yang for some victory card. As for Dai Viet, again, you know, Dai Viet's not... The core of Dai Viet is not on Persia's front lawn, so to speak. So, yeah, this is a lot more tantalizing than taking this, say.
Yes.
I mean, what's Dai Viet going to do? Get through Meng Yang and Vijayanagar to fight him? Probably yes, but...
Yeah, I've got to say that Dai Viet is possibly... You know, maybe looking southwards...
Well, he's not been taking his victory cards
whatsoever.
No, I
think he's definitely just decided, you know, who wants to win anyway. Yeah. He's far more interested in, you know, being a proud programmer.
Well, there's the thing. If he had his 6,000 points from these scorecards, he'd be right up at number two for himself right now.
But I suppose okay.
That would mean shanking a lot of players, though. Uesugi, Ayutthaya, and Korea. That's...
Yeah, well, I think shanking Korea and Uesugi would probably be something he could live with. But Ayutthaya, who's been with him from the beginning, although with Karsten now in there instead of Fido, could he justify it going, well, I didn't backstab Fido.
Yeah. Well, Ayutthaya, or rather Karsten in Ayutthaya, has been continuing to build up the development here. It's getting super expensive. But I guess that's why they're in their golden era right now. This is the Ayutthaya golden era.
As you can see them all there, manning the barricades in Ayutthaya.
Okay, not too shabby.
None too shabby at all. See? Oh, apparently D-Note is now the Shogun.
Oh, right. So, of course, he took Kyoto, mm-hmm. which means that you you do transcend into becoming the Shogun yourself. Mm-hmm. So he gets to enjoy some bonuses there, although he doesn't exactly have daimyos under his...
Not that many daimyos command. Last time I checked, no.
I mean, I don't think the Oda clan is going to be rising up and securing much right now. Mm-hmm. Nobunaga, just a little bit late to the party.
Yeah, he's like showing a lack of ambition, Nobunaga. No, never mind.
No. Oh. But it's actually peace in the world right now.
Peace reigns. That's...
Can't get behind this. And this blue on blue, I mean, I don't have the best of eyesight. I can't tell at a glance where the border is here. Something needs to be driven between them. Let's say Dai Viet linking up. Or maybe Ching doing the mother of all comebacks.
Yes, this will be... The Shogun is a regency.
Not quite Nobunaga, but it's Norifusa II.
He's a 12-year-old.
They're not that great either. 314. Got it where it counts, I suppose. Worse. But there we go. I knew this alliance with Korea was there. It's
back again. What happened?
It's there and back again. A short tale of Uesugi and Korean friendship. Oh, from beyond the grave, yes. Yamana's trying the best they can. And D-Note's just going, oh, not the manpower again. Anything but the manpower.
It burns, precious.
Well, he's going in. We'll see if he can manage it.
Stand back, chaps. Well.
He's got this.
I think he's staying. Yeah, no, it was one hell of a beating in the end.
Yeah, but kiss goodbye half his manpower once again. You want to lay any dibs on the next war then? I mean, Brunei was saying everyone's ganging up on him, but he's still got some healthy alliances. Ethiopia, it's not long before Vijayanagar will be coming back. In fact, it'll be 1 year, do you think? Vijayanagar is maybe, along with Persia, getting in position for a bit of a beatdown here?
Unless, of course, they're worried about the rebels. It's going to be one or the other.
Well, that's what we heard before. Mm-hmm. You know, can't trust these Ethiopian rebels.
No. So, yeah, we'll see what happens there. Willie's Hinduness. Oh, our laser is at war with someone. And Trintragula is also at war with someone.
With Kilwa. The Kilwan conquest of Gabon. Isn't that in Top Gear?
I don't know. I don't have an Amazon Prime account.
So. Oh. Okay, it looks like Kilwa have managed to find some ambition. They want to tear down Mali. And Inca's joining in.
All right, this looks like very much like a Mali sandwich we've got going on here.
Aye, Mali were a little low on friends here. In fact, their only friends were Naples and Yamana, and Naples have gone, whoa now, well, said alliance.
I think Yamana was an ex-friend after he conquered Manga.
Ah.
I don't know if Yamana would be kind of helping out the guy who took Manga from him.
No, I don't think so. But still, Naples stepped back and went, not my problem. So let's look at this.
Johan truly is a master diplomat. You know, you can always rely on him.
Kiowa has massive military bonus over Mali here. That's 25 to 23. That's better cannons and better tactics. Inca also enjoying tech 25. So the
and
Malians...
is that Persia turning up there as well? Did I see Starnan?
Well, now.
Yeah.
We've seen it all. Okay, are they actually involved in this war? No, they're just hanging around for a hoot. What in the world is Persia doing in the new world?
Are they just like chilling, doing their thing day by day?
Perhaps they're just gearing up for, I don't know, some Paraguay?
No idea. They just kind of turned up. Unless there's some deeper game going on here with the Axis of Evil, which we don't know which side that is. We will let people decide.
Never quite know with Star.
Oh, Johan has decided to go to war with someone.
Oh, okay. They couldn't have joined in the Mali War because they were too busy eating Tlemcen.
I'm sure
and
they
I
could
tell
have.
You, with 20 production cloth province at 41 development, I'd be wanting that as well. They decided he doesn't need claims or anything. Well, no, he needs his claim on Kasdir, but he's going for it.
Mm-hmm. And going for it rather badly.
Oh.
His popiness is there.
Yeah, did he bring in the Pope? Wait, I'm very confused. Ah, the Pope is a vassal of Naples.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
So his holiness was kicked out of Rome, forced to become quasi-French, and also has to bend the knee to Naples.
It's quite a humiliation for His Holiness.
Mm,
I was speaking of humiliation.
Now, is this before or after your
I've had my self-development talks. I can now.
Okay.
I mean, how many men did he send in there?
30,000 with 4 and 8 as backup.
14, 10, 10. So,
outgunned,
but not outnumbered.
Yeah. The thing is, Clemson have that military tech for better cannons and brought more cannons.
Bringing on the cannons, did he? Should we go down and see how our laser's getting on here?
He's getting our sandwiched right now. Let's see. He does have a fair few fortifications, but they've been falling fast. They're just old, outdated ones. Seems like the Malian army is grouped together here, and wow, it's cool. What kind of hat's that?
I don't know.
Looks like a metal sombrero.
It actually looks like, you know, some sort of Japanese hat.
Mm-hmm. Well, maybe they took inspiration when they took manga. Mm-hmm. But what's he going to do? Now, he certainly can't save Brazil.
I don't know.
But maybe he can kind of loop around the back here and attack from the south. We have seen Kiowa fight before with some miserable results when he into a static, ungeneraled Pasai stack and still managed to lose.
Yes. However, maybe, you know, Trintragula has been, like, in training.
Possibly. It has his own Rocky-style montage. Running down the streets. And
yes. With a kind of soft rock theme going in the background there. And Starnan's gone to war with someone, but that's not really news.
No, I suspected Paraguay is going down, but why would he do this? That just invites more victory cards, unless he's making a colonial nation here. Don't know what his end game there is, but he doesn't seem keen on fighting.
I wonder where Trintragula's victory card, does he have one on Gabon?
Didn't he take all of his victory cards by now?
He just wants it.
I mean, he could have just probably asked nicely for Gabon. This is our laser here, but
you know, it's not exactly, you know, the most prime real estate in all of Africa.
No, but okay. Oh, he's made a tragic mistake, and he's actually divided up his forces here. And for that, he's suffering.
And that's despite having terrain advantages. It's just not enough.
No. Okay, he's realized. Do not reinforce defeat.
Yes. He's practicing the tactics of defeat here.
Oh,
there's a very unhappy looking Mali soldier there.
No, yeah. It's like, this wasn't worth it.
Time to go home. All right, now Katz has gone to war with Paraguay as well.
I'm surprised the Vigiana would have needed called in. I'm sure need is a relative term here. But this is important because that's a lot of their troops that are stuck overseas.
Yes,
wonder. If a certain warmongering nation. Well, okay, they've actually allied with Vijayanagar and Persia. Dai Viet is trying to unite a continent and a half here. He's doing all right for himself. And Persia like big friends. Look at that.
Yeah. I wonder what Ethiopia is making of this.
Not friends.
Yes, France is an ally.
Yeah. France continues to eat, but the thing is, we're at that stage in the game where our players are so strong that even a France like this isn't a worry for them as long as they work together against it. This ugliness here, though, when are our players going to fix Iberia?
Yes, people, come on.
This is...
Your fans need you.
These are services against borders. This is border gore like none before.
This is sort of...
I mean, just like...
Oh, look, I think there's Johan's army being beaten again.
Yeah. Oh, and being chased down by the Tlemcenis.
Has he got more cannons? Let's see.
The Tlemcenis still have their 10 cannons. Johan still has his 8.
I think he's got a few more now, but...
But I don't think he has a manpower. Oh, he's still got the manpower still to reinforce. He
definitely needs a bit more guns, though.
Aye. He's not taking Casdir. And the Pope doesn't seem to be... Oh, well, there's the Pope.
Yeah, how many divisions does Pope have?
Well, you treat him like he has 50,000, unless he is the subject of Naples there.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the Vatican soldiers, not from the Vatican.
-37% war score here, that's not ideal.
No, speaking of not ideal. Now, again, the Tlemceni have charged right into
slightly better tactics, but not quite as good morale.
Yeah, it's from that discipline bonus that the Tlemceni are enjoying. But a lot of this is down to how the division is formed here. So they've got reasonable amounts of cannons on the back, whereas the Neapolitan units are just like throwing in loads of loads of infantry divisions that are at low strength, so they're just getting shot through by the cannons.
More cannons, Johan. You know the answer.
Well, he's already...
Minus 55% war score, though. He's
already in debt.
Yes.
Yeah,
Gnivnom's gone to war.
Tlemcen will have their lands back yet.
Yes.
They might even gun down Ethiopia. All right, yes, indeed, the Golden Horde are going for it once again. Nogai and Lithuania both have to crumble. Is this another Ottoman war?
Yes.
Yeah, the Ottoman war calling in allies once again.
It's, has his ever-loyal Starnan joined in?
No. But then Ottomans have not called Persia into this war. No. Probably because Persia are enjoying their own war right now. Oh, what's this green on green? You can't even...
Yeah, I mean, this is... I mean, Starnan, if you want to fight someone...
Well, he's taking... Pick on someone your own colour. Green on green. With just a wee splash of Vijayanagari yellow there. Mali's not looking so good right now.
No, it's looking a bit grim here for our laser.
Interesting play by Kiowa, though, because as long as he's got an agreement with Vijayanagar that essentially says, don't kill me, he's got prime expansion opportunities into these African gold mines, and really, Ethiopia's not going to attack him. He can just tell everyone else to sod off and maybe someday secure the cape for himself.
Yeah, I wonder what Pasai is playing up.
Okay, he's going for it. He's mounted up all of his units, and but the staying power of the Kielwin units is just
the
so
seven morale
high.
There, Jesus. I mean, that is an awful lot of morale there.
Yeah, and that's Mali scent packing once more. Now, we should have a look at see why this is happening for them. When we look at ideas, they just haven't filled out idea slots at all. They've got quantity, and that's not going to make them fight better. They have discipline from their, who are these, the Mandika warrior spirits. But when it comes to ideas, you know, we have the defensive, offensive, even economic there. Well,
economic's not bad, gotta
feed that army, right?
Yes.
So I don't think Mali have anything that they can really say against this. They're just
prime
real estate for Kielwin expansion.
Outclassed here.
Regrettable, though, but still, this has been one of our laser's better better campaigns.
Is Johan, though, triumphing? Not exactly.
Triumph is a relative term.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. Did his army get...
They're there. They're reformed. More cannons.
More cannons than ever before.
And I think he's just sat back to kind of laugh at the Pope getting destroyed before he comes in with his own units.
Yes, how many
cannons? There we go, Tlemcen, scent packing.
Yes, big victory there.
The comeback is now.
Yes.
The Papal Regiment reduced to about 1,000 men. He'll be thinking how to come back from this, though. Not a heavy deficit, but still a deficit for them, and they're still in debt right now.
Yeah, but I think if they can win the war, get some land, things will look a bit better for them. Mm-hmm. Now, the Starnan has finished his war, has he?
Yeah, he has. The Ottomans also appear to have finished their war. What's with these, like, sandwiched nations here?
Now, I also got to say that he was very generous to his loyal Golden Horde ally.
Oh, yeah, Golden Horde obviously getting rightly rewarded with absolutely nothing. Not even getting the gold mine of Bashgrid or some permanent land of their own.
No, it's a bit of a sad.
But hey, maybe he didn't want that land.
No, I mean, maybe it's not good enough for him.
Maybe he didn't contribute enough. But perhaps that means that the Golden Horde have plenty of favors built up with the Ottomans. They've jacked up that trust really highly, so the Ottomans are unlikely to really turn on them. At least until they advance this front and then start thinking, well, really now. But it also means that the Golden Horde could call Ottomans into a war of their deciding. But there is the option there. I mean, the Golden Horde have actually said, yes, I'll join offensive wars. You don't have to. You can uncheck that. They won't like it. You won't be getting favors and trust is going to go down, but... You don't have to join in all their wars.
Looks like the Johan machine is back advancing.
I see Tlemcen is being sent packing once more, but I also see no more manpower for the Neapolitans. Almost no manpower and no money left for the Tlemcen as well, though.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't think Yuan needs manpower or money anymore.
Nah, they're just numbers, right?
Yeah.
As long as he's got gun.
Yes.
Now he's retaking the lands that were occupied. I don't think this fort was ever taken. It's just a level 2 fort there. He should blow right through it. He'll get Kastadir back. He's just keeping things interesting. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, obviously. Keeping the people entertained, edge of seat stuff here.
Yeah, I mean, he saw these kinds of wars going on with Paraguay and Mali and just like, that's not what people came for. They want to see the crushing action in North Africa.
Now, I don't think Paraguay actually lost any territory. What was their fate?
I don't know. Not seeing anything from them. They're not subjugated by anyone. No land seems to have changed hands. What were they fighting for? Maybe they were an ally with Mali? Don't think so.
No.
I do not know. Perhaps, they're not telling us anything.
Yeah. Come on, Star Nan Cats, tell us what were you playing at?
Well, I think I can see what they're playing at right here.
Yeah, but why fight in Paraguay for what essentially looks like sod all?
They'll have deep reasons, I'm sure.
A deeper game being played.
Mm. But it couldn't have been a very big peace offer because the truce is only lasting about 7 years or so. All right, so they crushed that fort and got it back.
Yeah,
but their other fort is currently being taken over.
Minus 47% war score. This is not quite an epic.
Probably not what he was looking for.
I don't think it was a plan.
Tlemcen are at the point of actually making demands here. Yeah. You will see this, and both of those, as well as some money.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like quite a bargain there, Johan. I'm sure you're considering it.
War exhaustion going up as well. Yeah, I don't really think this is the golden era of Naples, to be honest.
Not quite yet. Anyway, he's liberated all his own territory.
Yeah, he's taken it all back. A disease even broke out over in Kef, so that'll reduce the number of units that Tlemcen have to fight with. He should be able to flank, and this should be game, set, and match in favor of Johan.
Yeah, he's got the morale advantage. He's got the cannon.
He's got the everything. He's sent them packing once more. He should be able to just round off if he just kind of stops them from advancing further. Then it should be a shoo-in to win for him. It's one thing to lose a war. Losing a war that you clearly shouldn't lose is another. It's coming in from chat.
Yeah, well, I'm still wondering, you know, I'm sure that Starnan and Katz are going to say that he definitely won their little Paraguayan excursion. But it's a different level of victory here. Obviously, it's more of a higher plane.
But I'm wondering what the delay is on this war, because Ethiopia certainly don't have any truce right now. They're probably just shipping their units back from the New World. And why they're even there in the first place?
We just don't know.
No. Inca and Incan Minor. So the Incan-Paraguayan Imperialist
War. Wait a minute, Paraguay is Shia?
Paraguay is very Shia. Didn't you know?
Holy crap. No. Well, you live and learn. Did they force convert them? Is that what they did?
Oh, no,
they are
Sunni.
Oh, that's
no, the Sunni presence is coming from Persia here right now.
No, Persia is Shia, I'm pretty certain.
Yeah, Persia is Shia, Paraguay is Sunni. But still, what are they doing there?
Yeah. Come on, guys. Give us an answer.
No, they don't.
What's Pasai Shia?
Oh, Pasai was Sunni, and Pasai colonized this.
Yeah,
so that's
why they're Sunni.
Bit of Catholicism here, can't really get behind that.
Yeah, that's because they're Aragonese.
Toffs. Kiowa still enjoying their little outpost here. For what reason, I do not know. Maybe just...
trade.
No, it's only Mali that's bringing the trade here, and they're probably not even... Oh, wow, Kiowa.
Oh, Jesus, Kiowa. Talk about services to Border Gore here. Oh. We'll be knighting you after this.
Oh, boy. That's troubling. Not sure I want to keep looking at that.
Yeah,
like a virus just creeping up. But I'm just a hunch. Do you think he was targeting gold mines there?
Possibly, yes.
If we have a look at trade goods, we got the gold.
He left one. He left.
No, Did he? Did he just leave it? No. Well, he took one of them for sure.
And he's in a definitely in a better position.
Yeah, he'll be eyeing up the other gold provinces. A 15 development, bam, buck. Yeah, the bucks certainly flow out of here.
But will he regret turning down the opportunity to get manga? I mean, will.
I mean, that's dangerous to be in. Okay, it's wartime. Wow, the Vijayanagar-Bruneian imperialist war.
My goodness,
Vijayanagar has fooled us all. It was not Ethiopia that they were gunning down at all. It's Brunei. Brunei is now at war with. Take a deep breath. Vijayanagar, Buryatia, Daiviet, Majapahit, Majapahitan, Australia, Mongyang, Nepal, and Persia. And Brunei are alone.
Bring on the salt.
Okay, well, he is firmly ready for this. He's ready is another
ready
relative
is a,
concept.
Ready is a bourgeois construct, if you ask me.
So, perhaps he's going to regret turning on Majapahit, who have now turned back and said, oh, about victory cards, I happen to have some of my own.
Yes, nice victory cards. I think I'll take them.
Well, this is very interesting, but why would Vijayanagar be the one declaring here? This is another imperialist war. So
unless he's after Sri Lanka.
He'll be looking to take the capital here. He could be looking for Sri Lanka, but I mean, that's Majapahit's land. So.
Oh.
And that was, I can't remember exactly who, but a masterful tactician decided that that land would go to Pasak. I can't honestly remember.
Someone
was very handsome and clever.
Oh, so it must have been Bengal then.
So what's Brunei going to do? They are armed to the teeth on this one. And since this is an imperialist war, Brunei had all the boats?
Yes, all your boats belong to us.
Yeah, they do have 137 heavies with 241 lights. But when we look at the other side, they've been building up.
That's a lot of boats.
48 from Persia, 50 from Daiviet, 89 from Majapahit.
90 now, actually. This is clearly, we're going to need a bigger boat.
Yeah. They should have researched Haggis boats. They would have been better. But.
And then clearly, Bratton decided to walk away.
Oh, yeah. The Incans just broke the alliance quite a long time ago, it seems. Not rivalry, you know. We're not enemies here. We're just not.
They're consciously decoupling, I think, is the modern parlance for it.
Oh, boy. This is dangerous for Brunei, because they could well have trouble keeping their subjects later on.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's his capital still in London, because I think it was moved back to...
Let's see. No, he moved his capital back here to Brunei.
Well, that's a curious decision.
Why did he do that? I mean, doesn't look like anybody's jumping on him to take over Europe.
Mm-hmm. And it would definitely have been...
If there's one player I know...
Definitely made the imperialist war much harder.
If there's one player I know who can jump in on wars, that would be Johan. Will he actually jump over and go, actually... Britain has always been Italian land.
He wants to return back to his ancestral home.
Okay, there will be no messing with this
that's
fleet.
That's quite a fleet.
Brunei, they don't have naval ideas. I'm not sure if anybody has... Oh, Majapahit have naval ideas. Their heavies will blot out the sun.
Yes,
and they're the ones that brought 90 of them as well. The Bruneian fleet is all right here. I'm surprised they're not actually pinning in on the coast of Sarawak, because if they were able to destroy this, Brunei would lose all ability to project their power across the globe.
Yeah, it'd be like, game over, man. Game over.
Now, I wanted to check out how they were doing with their subjects, because if we look at this, okay, they're reasonably kept in line. They bring in plenty of dosh. They even give them extra merchants. If Brunei gets solidly hammered here...
Starnan's come off too early here. Got a bit excited.
Starnan has actually brought in a fairly, well, jack-of-all-trades admiral. They got the backup coming in, but Persia's losing some early boats. That's really hurting the morale there. Nope, Brunei decided it's not worth it.
Yes, they didn't want to fight that battle anyway. Now, I think the Philippines is getting a bit tough here.
Mm-hmm.
Ayutthaya is landing in the Philippines.
This is the war that people have been waiting for so long.
Well, it's not really. I mean, it's like everyone against...
Yeah.
It's not really much of a...
Well, Brunei does own, like, half the Americas.
Yeah, I mean...
But what is Inca going to do? I mean, Inca could finally decide that they're going to have their victory card and they're going to solidify themselves in first place. It's going to take a lot of transport boats to actually get a decent army on here, though. It doesn't really matter what Brunei have. We're looking at the coalition transports. 153. They could land 153 units here, but I think they would get pushed out pretty fast.
Well, definitely they would need to...
But they would have the element of surprise on their side.
Yes,
because...
it's certainly the certain level of tactical coordination here. Mm,
indeed. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I mean, it's definitely the salt is saltiness. As...
But perhaps they don't even necessarily need to do this. Whilst their armies are trapped there, it does mean that Britain... They don't even need to touch America. They can revolt on their own. But if they were to come down on Britain, where, you know, it's not that well defended...
Yeah, but still, you know, it's going to be a hard push on your naval range.
Hmm.
Just a bit.
Just a touch. Well, we'll see. We'll see how well they can coordinate. A lot of players like that is very difficult to coordinate.
Yes, he should have probably kept his capital in Europe.
Would have been safer there, I think. But this is extremely well defended and very hard to break through. Perhaps a very strong push right here to take out that unit, secure this, and then spread out a bit would be okay.
Yeah, but I think basically, I think Daniel's gambling that he can get reinforcements.
He could probably just force march around his own island within a month.
Yeah, I mean, I think he could get reinforcements there before.
Yeah, it does take a month to actually do a landing here. But if the coalition were to secure a province, then they could very quickly just land straight up, Normandy style, just go, go, go.
Yeah, I mean, that would definitely be disappointing for them. Now, are Lazar's involved in a war? I wonder who he's fighting.
What is the man up to? Tlemcen. He's perhaps bailing out Johan. No, Johan came, he saw, and he did conquer. 41 development Tlemcen right there.
Clearly feeding off the scraps from Johan's table here.
Ah, well.
His options are limited, you know.
Unless he wants to turbo develop manga for some reason.
Well, he's more wine. Why wouldn't he? Now, it appears that Fortress Brunei is Fortress.
Nobody's wanting to take the first step here.
Everyone wants someone else to bleed first. This is the mark of a good coalition.
The units are in place here. Yeah. The units are in place here, there, and everywhere. But they need to get on the boats. They need to talk to each other and say, where are we going?
It's rebels.
Interesting internal support there, but that doesn't really work when he has this many units just ready to crush.
Yes, he's definitely... I mean, you've got to wonder is how... You know, can they both sides sustain the war? You know, how long can both sides stay in this war?
If
I'd be clocking up war exhaustion from the loss of the Philippines.
If I had to give some sage advice, perhaps, to the coalition, they would want to tease him out by launching an assault on one side of the island. Maybe a small force here and a small force there. Because in chess, the pawns go first, and then you got to crack in. So whilst he's going to panic and try to defend that, and then you come in.
So you're saying Starnan should go in first?
Absolutely.
Fair enough.
No bias there. You just
send the pawns in first.
Yeah. Don't give him a general. Don't do anything. Just send them in. They exist to die.